Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As you can see and as you can hear, we are nearing the day of Arbaeen. Only one more day. This is the eve of Arbaeen, the night prior to the great human gathering, the greatest human gathering, so to speak. And as you can see, Karbala is packed with pilgrims that have flocked towards Karbala from all over the world. Millions have entered Karbala today, and alhamdulillah, everyone is safe and sound. This hashtag LNT, I'd like to welcome you guys to episode 43 of tonight's episode of season 2, to be specific. Now tonight, we'll be talking about a lot of things. We'll be talking about one act that will differentiate someone genuine from someone not genuine. It's service. The service that people give and provide for others. And it's also related to Arbaeen, as we've been mentioning over the previous episodes. So before we jump into tonight's topic, I'd like to the producer, Ahmed Ali, shout out to him, to give us insights of what's going on to Karbala, to tell you the atmosphere of this holy, blessed city on these blessed nights. As you can see, mashallah, the processions are moving along to Karbala, and one after the other, moving closer to the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. And as they walk, they lament, and they chant the name of Imam Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. The crowds are amazing. Through Bayn al-Haramain, everyone is just pouring love. Everyone is pouring tears, commemorating the tragedy, the 40 days after the martyrdom of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, the greatest human gathering. Processions are from different continents and different countries and different cities. But as you can see, different flags are being raised in the sky to resemble each person coming from a different country. But alhamdulillah, everyone will move into the shrine of Imam Hussein. From there, they'll go Bayn al-Haramain and exit the shrine of Abu al-Fadl Abbas. And what an honor it is to be serving and being amongst the pilgrims of Imam Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. Hopefully we can be with them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala count us as one of the Zuwar of Imam Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. But let's take a very quick break, come back to talk about tonight's topic. Once again, we do welcome everyone joining us tonight. As I mentioned, tonight's topic is a very important topic to shed light on, especially in this atmosphere. And one of the aspects that we need to talk about tonight, and we have to talk about it tonight, is service to others. And it basically means doing something for others, not looking for something in return, not looking for something to gain in return. Also means helping out people who sometimes are not capable of doing something themselves. Now, as you can see, millions are flocking towards Karbala. No one can, you know, set up a bed. They don't have time for that. They're walking. No one can really cook food. They don't have time for that. They're walking. The medical conditions, everything, they're walking. So so you probably get the full idea as to how important it is to serve individuals who are walking towards or walking for a specific purpose. Now, there are many different ways to serve others. It goes from simply carrying someone's groceries from a grocery store to their car, or to serving dinner to the guests that are over to your house. But serving people has one very beautiful taste to it. You're not only bettering your character, but you're bettering the character of anyone around you. Anyone affected by that service is affected, or their character is being bettered. Tonight, we want to focus on a specific service. A specific service that takes place in one specific place. If you're in Karbala, then just look around you and you'll see what I'm talking about. And if you're outside of Karbala and if you couldn't make it this year, then I hope, inshallah, that Imam Hussein TV provided you with enough inserts, enough coverage of the Arbaeen pilgrimage to see what people are doing for the Zuwar and how the Zuwar are entering the shrines of Karbala. But tonight, we want to focus on these services and on these pilgrims that are receiving the services from those mawakib, from those processions. That's why tonight's question is a very simple question. What services are offered to the pilgrims in Arbaeen? What services are offered to the pilgrims? Inshallah, we'll show the question and the number after this break. The number to call in is +964-774-067-1836. And let us know what you think about tonight's question. You can shoot us a text message. You can give us a call via WhatsApp. And you can shoot us a voice note. And we'll inshallah play them after the show because there's internet problems going on. But let's take a quick break. Come back to you guys very shortly. Once again, we do welcome everyone joining us tonight. Now, as we mentioned before the break, we're talking about services. We're talking about providing services for the millions who are flocking towards the Holy Shrine of Imam Hussein. That's why the question for tonight is very simple. It's shown at the bottom of the screen. What services are offered to the pilgrims? What services are offered to the pilgrims? Now, as everyone knows and everyone feels, serving others had a very beautiful taste to it. It's a very beautiful act that's commended not only in culture but in religion. In culture and religion and every single ethnicity that you ask, what's the value of serving others? And the value is priceless. Serving someone is the most beautiful act that someone can ever do in her or his life. It's not only an ethical topic. Service and serving others, it's not only an ethical topic, but a religious topic as well. Now, the Bible also says to everyone, where it calls everyone to serve God and serve others. In Galatians 5, verses 13, it says, "You, my brothers, you were called to be free, but do not use your freedom to indulge the sinful nature. Rather, serve one another in love." So we can really get to understand what St. Paul, the Apostle Paul, what he's trying to say. You've been given freedom. You were set free by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do whatever you want. But keep in mind that that freedom should not lead you towards deviation. That freedom should not lead you towards doing the wrong things. But instead, it should lead you to serve others with love. And inshallah, later on, we'll compare all of these verses and all of these lines. And we'll try to see, do they apply to the Arbaeen pilgrimage or do they not? If they do, then we'll find out how. Service to others, as everyone can understand, is a very important part of our life. As I mentioned, you carry something simple like the groceries for someone old, opening the door for someone when they can't able to, helping someone out in terms of providing them with food and so on and so forth. The respect that grows between you and the other person is huge. And let's not forget about the community. In order for the community to thrive, it needs service. And growing respect allows the community to thrive and grow stronger. With service comes respect. Why am I serving you? I'm serving you because I respect you, because you are the Za'ar of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Because your status is only known by Allah and no one else. I can give you whatever even if I provide you with my life, that's still not enough, because only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the status and the elevated status of the Zuwar of Imam Hussein, peace and blessings be upon him. And it's an extremely important part of service, and it's extremely important part of the community. And that's what we need to keep in mind, that in order for a community to strive and become prosperous is through service and one respecting the other. In Arbaeen, we witnessed the strong community, the global community, so to speak, that everyone arrives in the holy city of Karbala, everyone coming together under one banner. If I'm just looking right now, I'm seeing Africans, Persians, I'm seeing Arabs, I'm seeing people coming from the West, people from India and Pakistan, Mawakib from Tanzania, Iran, Azerbaijan, and so many countries. All of them coming here being one community, the community of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. This is why the banner right here that says Hussein unites us. This is very beautiful and very true. Because if it wasn't for Imam Hussein to be in Karbala, you would never see these services. You will never see these lovers of the Prophet Islam. And we reside in Karbala. After Arbaeen, it's going to be so depressing because all these mawakibs are gone, all the pilgrims are gone. These pilgrims bring comfort to the hearts of the people of Karbala. These mawakib and these services bring healing to the broken hearts of the people of Karbala. So imagine how important service is on an international basis, not just on a local basis. The servants of Imam Hussein alayhi salam do not hold back when serving the pilgrims. They offer anything. And without thinking of it twice, they don't think of something twice. If they want to serve tea right away, they serve tea. They're not going to think, oh, do I have the money for that or not? Why? Because they know that the thing that they're doing is absolute truth and is absolute beautiful. Look at it, go and ask anyone. They save up the entire year. And when it comes to Arbaeen, they still don't have the same amount. But subhanAllah, I've met many individuals like this, that when they come to the day of Arbaeen, when they come to serving, they do the calculations and say, you know what, we don't have enough. When Arbaeen passes by, they've hit their target. And they have extra money left. Why? Because there is something called Baraka within the money. And this is what the Ahlul Bayt emphasize on. When the pilgrims come from different countries to Arbaeen, they don't pack, you know, they shouldn't pack anything with them. Because the services which are provided in Arbaeen range from food to drink to medical services to accommodation and to even massages. If you feel tired, if your legs are tired, there are tens of mawaki providing just massages. You go into their mawaki, you go into their tent, their procession, and you'll see 10, 15 masseuses, so to speak, doing massage for the pilgrims of Muhammad alayhi salam, getting them ready to go back on their feet and walk towards Karbala. This is the kind of services that are provided during this great ziyarah and this great human gathering. Now it's evident that we see that even the motive of those that serve the visitors of Muhammad alayhi salam, they serve with the best foods. And ranging from different foods, they're not just serving one dish. As I mentioned a few nights ago, when you walk from Najaf to Karbala, from anywhere to Karbala, you'll see each mokib providing different types of food. Some people serve boiled eggs. Some people serve shawarma. Some people falafel, timan marag, you know, rice and karma, so to speak. And even if you were to look at other services, for those who are coming from Pakistan and can't eat these kind of foods or have Pakistani background or Indo-Pak background, you'll see even some mawakib serving butter chicken. They're serving specific foods that the zuwar can be able to eat. And how amazing it is for everyone to actually contemplate on the service and take it into consideration. Why are these people serving? Why are they serving? You see, every mawqib serving water. Why are they doing it? What are they gaining from it? Other than spending money. They're spending money just to feed and quench the thirst of the za'ar coming towards Muhammad alayhi salam. Why do they do that? Why? Because Imam Ali Talib, peace and blessings be upon him, or the Messenger of Allah says, whoever quenches the thirst of a believer with water, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the giver, the person doing this deed, 70,000 hasanah. 70,000 good deed, and he will move from 70,000 sins. So imagine the kind of reward that these individuals are getting. Sometimes in life, it's not only about money, it's not only about financial gain. Sometimes we need to look at spirituality and look at how we can gain spiritual elevation. And that's what we need through these mawakib and through these services. Everyone aims at one thing, and that's satisfying. Everyone aims at one thing, and that's satisfying the zuwar of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. You see people opening up their homes. When the za'ar comes, a few nights ago it was raining. The zuwar, it's pretty muddy when it rains in Iraq on the way to Karbala. when the Zawar arrive at any mokib, they have a washing machine. They make the Za'ar take off their clothes, give them brand new clothes, they'll wash their clothes and give it back to the Za'ar. This is the kind of service. They want them to come to come. Today, I was actually amazed. Today, see, everyone right here, they serve food. They serve water. They serve tea. They serve various drinks. Whatever you want, sweets. They serve everything. But today, there was actually one interesting small mokib of 5-6 people who, they have a small stand and they have colognes and perfumes. And all six of them, 5 or 6 of them, they stand in front of the mokib and they spray the zawar with perfume and cologne. Because as you know, when you're walking that much of a distance, you might start smelling a bit differently. Although that smell to the angels is nicer than any smell on this earth. The most expensive cologne right now, it's not compared to the smell of the za'ar to the angels. But yet, this mokib still sprays every za'ar that walks by a few sprays to make them feel, to make them smell better as they're walking towards Imam Hussein alayhi salam. This is the kind of service that is provided during Arbaeen. A lot of people think that, you know, these people, are they doing it out of, you know, are they getting money out of it? You know, you see each mokib with 10, 15 individuals just working so hard day and night, 24/7. There's one mokib a day, they serve 2,000 meals. A day, 2,000 meals. Why are they doing it? They're volunteers. Yesterday I met doctors who have just come from the UK and the US just to come here and provide medical services for the Zawar. Why? This is what we need to take in. Why are they doing it? They're doing it so everyone can feel comfort when they go into the shrine of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So as they walk towards the shrine of Imam Hussein, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants, as according to Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, he says, whoever eases the way of the za'ir, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will count him as one of the martyrs in between Imam Hussein alayhi salam and between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, between the hands of Rasulullah. So imagine, whoever comforts, whoever eases the way, facilitates the way to the Holy Prophet Muhammad, he'll see the doors and the gates of heaven opening for him and her. So let's take this in and comprehend these individuals that are lamenting, these individuals that are walking towards the Holy Shrine of Muhammad, and be sure. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant everyone the ability to serve Imam Hussein in any way possible. Whatever you feel that you can serve, do it. And if it's something you need, that's absolutely beautiful. Thank you very much for joining us today. Do stay tuned for the upcoming episode. And don't forget us in your du'as. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.